What is heat? Heat is equal to thermal energy. And what is thermal energy? Thermal energy is the total energy which includes in a material or an object. And the next topic is, what is temperature? A temperature is the quantity that which defines how cold a body or hot a body which we measures. Around the atmospheric temperature around that. And the measurement of temperature. Next topic is measurement of temperature. We measure the temperature around thermometer. Many kind of thermometers we use, but the common is mercury in glass type. It measures the expansion and contraction of the temperature. To fix the temperature on a scale, zero shows melting ice and 100 degree shows steam boiling around 760 mm mercury. These all on a scale we have the separation between equal intervals, that is called degrees, and this scale is called Celsius scale. If we talk about the Fahrenheit scale, degree shows 0 degree and 232 Fahrenheit shows 100 degree. And if we want to convert or maybe call change that Celsius to Fahrenheit, then the formula we used, TC equals to 5 by 9 2 minus T1 TF, where TC is called Celsius temperature and TF shows Fahrenheit temperature. The only one value of the temperature is equal in Celsius and Fahrenheit, that is minus 40 degree centigrade, which is identical in both measures like Celsius and Fahrenheit. The next topic is boiling point. What is boiling point? That point at which water boils at 100 degree centigrade at sea level. And what is freezing point? that point at which the water freezes at 0 degree centigrade at sea level. The next topic is heat capacity. The internal energy at which the body warms or cools at 1 degree centigrade, that is called heat capacity. And what is specific heat capacity? At which the body warms or cools of 1 gram material at 1 degree centigrade. 1 gram of material at 1 degree centigrade. The next topic is what is efficiency? If we want to calculate efficiency of an object or a body, then we use to know about the temperature increases or decreases, then efficiency is denoted by eta, and this is the formula to calculate efficiency of a body, where T2 is the temperature which increases and the T1 is the temperature which the at actual. And what is coefficient of performance? It is denoted by K, and the formula is K equals to Q2 minus Q2 upon W. It means Q2 is heat and W is work done. We know work done is equal to T2 minus T1, then the formula becomes K equals to Q2 upon T2 minus T1. Now we take the problem on based of coefficient of performance and efficiency. A refrigerator works under a reversible cycle between temperature 300 Kelvin and 400 Kelvin, then we want to calculate thermal efficiency and coefficient of performance. Then T1 is 300 Kelvin and T2 is 400 Kelvin. Then efficiency equals to 1 minus T2 minus T1. Then efficiency is 1 minus 400 upon 300. Then efficiency equals to 0.25% or 25%. We want to calculate coefficient of performance. K equals to Q2 by T2 minus T1. Then K equals to T2 upon T1 minus T2. 300 upon 400 minus 300. 300 upon 100. The answer will be 3. Then the coefficient of performance is equal to 3. Now the next topic is Newton's law of cooling. This law states that the heat losses is directly proportional to the internal energy. Let me take the example. A water boils at 40 degree centigrade to 30 degree centigrade has much lesser time than water freezes at 30 degree centigrade to 20 degree centigrade. The next topic is quantity of heat. If we talk about the internal energy, we know that total energy of the material is known as thermal energy, but we don't call it heat because the heat is the total energy which calculate about the temperature decreases. The then heat equals to energy calculated when temperature decreases. And the quantity of heat we measured in degree Celsius. Now we have take the many examples of specific heat and their values. Materials and specific heat. Ice 2100, it measured in kilogram per joule and Kelvin. Iron 140, lead 130, water 4200.